Sebastian Rodriguez, the same thing is happening to me in Rose's drawer. Who's Rose? Hey guys, you're probably here because you want to know all about eczema and tips on how to treat it. Well, I'm going to answer that question, along with many other questions in this week's Responding to Your Comments, where we look at fun questions, we look at science-based questions, but most importantly, we look at the evidence to support those answers. Clips producer, hi Abraham, I'm commenting since the last three videos of yours to make a video on how to treat eczema. I really hope you can make it. Thank you in advance. Clips producer, thank you for your comment, and thank you for constantly commenting so I do this topic. Like I said before, we get a lot of comments, it's very easy for me to miss them. So keep commenting and eventually it will get my attention and I will make a video on it. So eczema, let's begin with it. It's a very big topic, I'm sure you will all be aware of this, and I could quite easily do a video which is over an hour long on this, but don't worry, I'm not gonna do a video which is over an hour long. What I will do is a kind of eczema fact sheet, let's call it that, where I talk about treatments and tips that I think many patients either aren't aware of or they're not doing, and it can make a massive difference in your treatment. So without further ado, let's begin. So what is eczema? Well, there's many different types of eczema. Probably the most common type of eczema is what we call atopic eczema or atopic dermatitis, where the symptoms are dry skin, itchy skin, cracked skin. These are the common symptoms. Now, eczema is more commonly seen in children, but you can get it when you're an adult as well. And it's what we call a chronic condition. So it's a long-term condition that you need to control, but some people do grow out of eczema. So as they get older from childhood to adult, they do grow out of eczema and they no longer get it. Now that's a very brief explanation of eczema, but the reason I kept it brief is that you probably searched up for this video to find out on tips and tricks on how to treat eczema. So you probably know all about the condition. But in case you don't know about the condition fully, I will leave more information in the description below, so feel free to check it out for more information. So let's talk a little about treatments. Now firstly, the bad news is that with eczema, we don't actually have a treatment that's gonna cure the condition. And what I mean by that is, let's say for example you had a chest infection, you go to your doctor, they might give you antibiotics, and if they do, the antibiotic is gonna kill the bacteria and it's gonna get rid of that infection, so it's a cure. With eczema, we don't have a cure as such, so we don't have something that's gonna stop and cure the itching, we don't have something that's gonna stop and cure the dry skin. But what we do have is many different treatments that's gonna help control the symptoms, and over time, it's gonna help improve them too. And before we go into treatments and creams, because we're going into lots of detail on that, the first tip, if you wanna call it that, that I'm gonna give you, is all about vitamin D. There's been some really new, exciting research done, and there has been a link found between low vitamin D levels and worsening symptoms of eczema. Okay, so this is definitely something that's worth maybe discussing with your healthcare professional if your symptoms are worsening. In the UK, the Department of Health recommends that all patients, everyone, takes a vitamin D supplement between October to March. And that's basically because we don't get enough sunlight during those months. So best thing to do is speak to your pharmacist about them, see if you're safe and suitable to take them. You can buy them over the counter and they can give you the recommended dose for an adult or a child or whoever. I will also leave more information in the description below about this for you too. Now let's move on to emollients, the most important part of eczema treatment, because what the emollient is gonna do is it's gonna produce an oily layer on your skin and it's gonna hold and trap that moisture in your skin. So it's gonna help improve your symptoms and help reduce your symptoms from getting worse. Now, one thing that's really important is that your dermatologist or your doctor or whoever gives you a sample pack of emollients. This is very common practice and they will usually have this. They give you a sample pack of different emollients to try, see which one works for you, and also to make sure that you don't react to them. So see which one works for you, make sure you don't react to any of them, but make sure that you really like that emollient. Make sure you like the texture of it, make sure you like the smell of it, make sure you like the feel of it. This is really important. Now, the reason I say you really need to like your emollient is because you're gonna be using a lot of it. And to get the most out of it, you need to be using it at least twice a day. But if your eczema is flaring up, so your symptoms are getting worse, you need to be using your emollient probably every 2 hours. And also, you need to be using quite a lot of emollient. So it's actually recommended that an adult uses 500 grams of emollient per week. That's right, 500 grams, so one big tub is usually 500 grams. And for children, it's recommended that children use 250 grams per week. So as you can see, emollients are highly underused. I see it in practice all the time. Patients always wanting steroid creams instead, you know, but they really should be using your emollient. So you should be using your emollient to prevent your symptoms from getting worse. And over time, it will help improve your symptoms too. I did tell you this is gonna be a big topic, but staying on emollients, a few of the tips when using it: always apply it in the direction of hair growth. This is to avoid blocking hair follicles. And don't rub it on vigorously, because this can actually trigger an itch, and then that can make your eczema worse. If you are prescribed a topical steroid cream or ointment, continue using your emollient. Don't stop using your emollient. And there's no actual rule which one to apply first, but just leave about 20 to 30 minutes between your emollient and steroid, and this is going to prevent it from diluting. And once again, staying on the topic of emollients, if you do use aqueous cream, please stop using it. It actually makes eczema worse. It contains something called SLS, which stands for sodium lauryl sulfate, and it makes eczema worse. You might already know about this, but if you don't, please stop using it. And also, it's a good idea to use your emollient as a soap substitute. This can make a big difference. And when you do come out of the shower, pat your skin dry with a very soft towel. This can help. And then reapply your emollient everywhere immediately. These can all help. Please also remember that there is a fire risk associated with paraffin-based emollients. Most emollients do contain paraffin, and the paraffin is actually responsible for that greasy layer that we get on the skin that's going to help the eczema. Now, the paraffin can slowly seep in your clothes and your bedding and anything that touches your skin, really. And then that material can then become a lot more flammable. So if you do smoke or if you have any sort of open fire source and it gets on that material, it can ignite a lot quicker and burn a lot stronger. So be aware of that. I did make a video about this not long ago on what to do to reduce the risk. One of the most important things that you can do is wash your clothes and bedding often in a really high temperature wash to try and get that paraffin out. And also avoid an open fire source. You know, if someone smokes, avoid them. Any sort of open fire source, just avoid it to reduce your risk. I hope this doesn't put you off using your emollient. This risk has been, you know, something for a long time, but it's good for you to be aware of it to reduce your risk. Thank you for your comment. I really hope my little eczema fact sheet video helps you and helps anyone watching this video, really. But if you do have any of your own tips, please leave a comment below too. I'd love to read it. I'm sure everyone watching this video would love to read it too. Now let's move on to the next comment. Christopher Melville, great video, very informative, but will you please tighten that watch strap? It's driving me nuts. Christopher, thank you for your comment. This is from the how to use a nasal spray video. I've said it before, I will say it again. People that watch YouTube have the highest attention to detail, honestly. The kind of stuff that you guys comment, it really baffles me sometimes at how do you actually notice this stuff. So, I mean, this is a different watch that I'm wearing today, but yeah, I do like to have a looser watch strap. I don't know why, I don't like a watch too tight on my arm. This is a bit tighter than I usually have it. But yeah, thank you for commenting and I will try my best to tighten it more if that makes you happy. UG Lee, I did it to be cool. I will never do it again. UG Lee, thank you for your comment. I'm glad you're never gonna do it again. And if you're wondering which video this is from, it's actually from the shisha or hookah video where I talk about all about how bad it is for your health, you know. And to summarize, shisha or hookah, whatever you wanna call it, is pretty much as bad as smoking cigarettes. And by that, I mean it causes lung disease. It causes various different cancers, such as lung cancer, cancer of the esophagus, cancer of the stomach, cancer of the throat, and many different diseases. What I will do is I'll leave a link up here and in the description below. So if you haven't watched that video and you do smoke shisha, or you know someone that smokes shisha, then show them that video or watch it and tell them all about it. And it looks like we've run out of time again in this week's episode. If I missed your question, if I missed your comment, I'm really sorry. We are getting so many comments these days, so it's quite hard to get back to everyone. So as I say every single week, if I missed your comment, please leave another comment and I'll try my best to get back to you in another episode of responding to your comments. Always remember you're awesome and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.